Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Jonah Yule. I am the head instructor of 510 Judo, and I'm also the tournament director of the recently passed Bay Area Judo Championships. That was on Sunday, July 16th at Castro Valley High School. This video will be long and kind of boring, so I imagine that not many people will watch it, especially not all the way through, but I just want to get some thoughts down. I'll edit it down so that it's kind of sort of watchable. But I just want to basically take this time to review our very first tournament and give out lots of thank yous and apologize for the things that went wrong, celebrate the things that went well. So by the end of the day, people were coming up to me and saying, hey, that was a great tournament. Hey, that was great. That was awesome. We had a great time, which is awesome. That's exactly what we wanted to hear. And overall, I would agree. I think it really went well, thanks to the efforts of everybody, including myself, of course, but you know, it takes a team. It takes a huge team. And there were a lot of people that helped out. Anything that went wrong is pretty much due to my inexperience as a tournament director, and I'm gonna fix those things next time around for sure. So let's start with, usually we start with the good news, but let's start with the bad news. The bad news is, there were a couple things that I really messed up on, and I want to apologize for those. One is that we were using Smooth Comp. Smooth Comp is great. Pretty much everybody uses Smooth Comp these days. USA Judo events use Smooth Comp. Small local events use Smooth Comp. Jiu-Jitsu, Muay Thai, any kind of fight sports. Most people are using Smooth Comp these days, at least in the United States. One of the things that about Smooth Comp, it's supposed to make the tournament run smoothly, right? That's what you want. You want things to run on time and smoothly and predictable. For the most part, it did a pretty good job of that, okay? I did promise in several places, on email to tournament participants, on social media, several different places, I said, we will have a screen that has the fight order on it, and it will be constantly updated, so you won't have to pull out your phone. You can just go up to the screen at the tournament site and be like, oh, where's my, just like, you know, at the airport, and you're looking for your flight. Although everyone looks at that on their phone nowadays anyways. But back in the old days, the TV screen was the only place you could get it. The latest update before phones, right? Before smartphones. So you go up to the screen, you're like, oh, let's see, where's my name? Where's my, oh, there I am. Oh, good. Oh, what? I've been moved to mat 3. You know, all that stuff. And I promised that we would have that available, and we just didn't. We didn't have it available. And it was the reason for, we actually did have a spare TV screen and a spare computer to set that up and have that running. What we didn't have was time in the morning to set that up. You know, time got away from us. We had to be there 5:30 a.m. to set up, and there was a couple snafus that we had to work out, so things didn't go super smoothly starting in the morning. So we just ran out of time, and then the tournament was starting, and I was like, we got to get these matches going, you know. So, apologize for that. That was something that I promised to deliver and did not deliver. We were supposed to have 4 mats, okay? The whole time we've been planning for 4 mats. The day before, if you were there, you saw we were using the wrestling mats. And we had the covers on top of them. The day before the tournament on that Saturday, the 15th, I got a call that actually we're only going to have 3 mats available because, you know, the mats, they're lent out to somebody else. They're supposed to come back. They didn't come back on time. What are you going to do? Only 3 mats. So I had to scramble, reassemble the mat assignments, and put them all on 3 mats. At that point, it looked like the tournament was going to go until 7 at night, just on matches alone. And then, you know, a couple more hours to break down and clean up. Boy, that's going to suck. Because who likes a tournament that goes into the evening? Nobody, right? If it starts in the morning, goes into the night, nobody likes that. So, went to bed just that night, Saturday night, being like, okay, well, that's how it's going to be. Sunday morning, woke up, and I was like, oh, what if we divide one of the mats, one of the 3 mats, and put the little kids on those 2 smaller mats? So, that was my idea. That's what we ended up doing. It worked out. It worked great. So on Sunday morning, when everyone woke up and checked their mat assignment and match number and match first match start time, that was based on us having three mats. Then I had to wait for the head referee to get there at 8 a.m., 8:30, and physically look with his own eyes and look at the mats up and say, yes, that's okay. Fortunately, he did, and he said, I approve of that. So I was like, great. Now I have to scramble and reassign all these matches to different mats. And so that was, there was some confusion there. A bunch of matches got moved up, right? So obviously they're not going into 7 at night anymore. We're moving some matches from, you know, mat 3 to the newly invented mat 4. After we're done with small kids, you know, under 7, under 9, under 11, then we reconfigured the mats and made it so we just have three big mats instead of two big mats and two small ones. You know, teenagers and adults obviously need a full-size mat. So we did that. Then we had to, again, reassign more matches, and that changed people's start times again. So a couple of people that were in veterans and were in the senior division, I was able to, I don't think anyone missed their matches because of that. Thankfully, Smooth Comp has this feature where you can send out emails and text messages directly from smoothcomp.com and say, hey, you know, your match time has changed. Please check. Please come as soon as possible so that you can have your match, you know, in a timely manner. The third thing that I personally messed up on was I did not get scorekeepers and volunteer scorekeepers really set in their time slots. People did volunteer and they sent emails and text messages, hey, I'll be there to scorekeep. I can do it. I've done it before, no problem. Or, you know, I think I can do it. You know, I'm pretty good with that stuff. You can just train me. And I had so much stuff going on. I didn't delegate properly. So I didn't get back to those people and say, great, let's put you on mat 1 from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. and then let's have a sign-up sheet and all that stuff. I didn't do that. I was just kind of like, oh, people will show up. And then it was 9 a.m. and wherever the scorekeepers, I didn't know. All those people that volunteered, they eventually showed up. But because I hadn't gotten back to them with specifics about, you're going to be on this mat at this time, thank you so much, blah, 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 we did not start in a timely manner. So again, late starts to the tournament. We're supposed to start at 9, actually started at 9:30. So that wasn't cool. So some of the things that went on behind the scenes that I messed up on that kind of bit into the profitability of the tournament. One thing I did was I ordered way too many medals, way too many. We ended up having, if you look at Smooth Comp, it says you had 100 gold medals, 88 silver medals, and I think, you know, 68 bronze medals, something like that, that we gave out. So less than 300 medals altogether. I ordered about 950 medals, okay, at a cost of several thousand dollars. Because of that one mistake, I don't think I made any money on the tournament. I have to go back and look. I may have made a little bit. I don't know. I may have lost a little bit. I don't know. But in experience, basically there was some math behind it. What I did was I looked at every single division that we had set up. And I said, what if every single division is filled with at least three people? If every single division is filled, okay, these are the number of divisions, okay, times three, then we're gonna need this many. And then I figured, oh, well, there's gonna be some divisions that have only two competitors, right? That always happens. So I was like, let me get a few less bronze medals. Then I thought to myself, oh, we're doing true double elimination with two bronze medals, with two bronze medals for, you know, large brackets that run double elimination. For the smaller brackets, we had round robin. So for the bigger brackets, 5 and up, we had true double elimination, which leads to two bronze medals, which is the same way they do it in the Olympics and the World Championships. And then I was like, oh, there's going to be more bronze medals that we need. So I ordered more bronze medals. Of course, not every single division was filled. Obviously, there are fewer overall participants on the female side. Unfortunately, we wish there were more, wish there was equal numbers. But there just aren't the numbers there. So I miscalculated on that. I miscalculated on that and a bunch of other ways. So if you're throwing a tournament, just keep that in mind. Okay, thank yous. I have so many thank yous. Number one, and I know I'm going to miss somebody, and more than one person. I had a list, but then it was taking me too long to make the list. So I'm just going to try to do it off the top of my head in video form. And I'll try to, if I forget you, I'm so sorry. Running a tournament is kind of like what I've heard. It's like making a movie. You can't do it yourself. It's impossible to make a movie by yourself, right? You need a, maybe you could do one by yourself. You could do a small movie, right? You could be the writer, director, producer, editor, cameraman, and the star, and the only person on camera. You could do that. You could make a movie like that. I know people do. But that's going to be a small movie, right? It's not going to be a huge blockbuster movie that a lot of people can enjoy. And we were trying to make, you know, a medium-sized movie. So we needed a big crew. And let's see. So basically, I want to say thank you to Minobu Shibuya's, Minobu Sensei, and Angelo Kagawan, who's one of our judo guys and judo dads over here at 510 Judo. They were there all day Saturday, helping me weigh in and make brackets, and all day Sunday. And they basically stayed until a bitter end, helped me pack up stuff. So set up stuff in the morning, pack up stuff at night. So I got to give a shout out to those guys just because they were the two people that I saw the most with my own eyes. I know there was a ton of people doing stuff that I didn't even know about. Like, for instance, I don't even know who set up the tables with the extension cords that were taped down really nicely. I think it was Gaetano, but I'm not sure. But that was, I went away and came back and that was done. But big shout out to Angelo and Minobu Sensei for being there, and also to Victor Nguyen, who's a judo black belt, and he goes to Monero Jiu-Jitsu in Emeryville. He stayed at the end and helped pack up, and he brought two of his friends, and I didn't even know. I don't think they even participated in the tournament, and they were just like, yeah, we'll help for like 2 hours, you know, at the end of the day on Sunday in the heat, packing up stuff, you know. So that was cool. Thank you for that. Appreciate that very much. Now, I'm trying to remember everyone that was there bright and early in the morning. Let's see. Lee Baker was there. Brian Takamatsu was there. Gustavo and his dad. I don't remember his dad's name, but Gustavo was there. His dad was there. Oh my God. I know I'm going to forget somebody. This sucks. Gaetano, obviously. Gaetano was with me in the very beginning. Gaetano met me at the dojo at 5 a.m. and we loaded up his car with stuff, and then we took it over to the caravaned over to the tournament site, got donuts together, stuff like that. I know I'm gonna miss somebody. This sucks. Sensei Nico was there bright and early in the morning with his wife Rebecca. And they were helping to set up. Man, I know I'm going to miss somebody. This sucks. Oh, man. Anyway, okay, moving on from the morning, but I know there's a bunch of people I'm missing. Okay, I'll finish this later. That's the morning.
Body in two different places. I'm still playing for both teams. Sometimes it feels I was born with two faces. I feel the smoke climbing down my cheeks. I hear the jokes and I smell the